Hello guys, welcome to my channel. At this time, I would like to share about how to carry out crankshaft deflection measurement. We have 4 set dual fuel diesel engine, and at this time, we will carry out 4 number 4 MGE. The procedure are as follow. We have to make sure that the engine under secure condition by closing the starting valve, set the lever to stop, set the controller to local manual, and so on. For marine diesel engine, vessel should be afloat. Measure in one position is the most accurate. Use calibrated precision dial gauge or digital gauge. Measure the deflection one by one in cylinder to avoid cooldown. Use signaling, whistle, or hammering during operation of turning gear. And don't forget, wear proper PPE. The engine specification is Wärtsilä W6L36DF, and the instrument we use for the measuring is deflection indicator Prisma DI5. The tools required for this job are as follow: Prisma DI5, deflection indicator, waste rack, writing pad and the pencil, and flashlight. Also, don't forget to prepare the turning gear remote with the turning gear already engaged to the flywheel. First step is installing the transducer to the crankweb. The length of the transducer must be fit to the gap between the crankweb. When the transducer length is not fit to the crankweb gap, we can disassemble the extension bar. The spare of extension bar, you can find it inside of the box of the instrument. You can check the instrument overview of Prisma DI5 in my other videos. I will explain about this instrument. And then next step is carry out zero adjustment of digital measurement tools. At first, push power to start the instrument. Push the reset before fitting the transducer within crankshaft. And then adjust the transducer to reading between minus 0.5 to 0.5, but it must be very close with the zero. You can see now it's coming down minus 0.4, then 0.3, and then we can nearby zero, about minus 0.2, then press the zero button, and then you can continue with the measurement. The measurement started on the point of A. It is about 5 to 10 degrees on the BDC. And then make sure the turning direction is correct, because if not correct, then it will broke the transducer. And then turn carefully until reaching to 90 degrees. Then if after confirm it is 90 degrees, then stop the turning gear and lock the turning gear, and then take the measurement. At current position, the reading is minus 0.001 or 1 per 1000. And for the writing, according to the manual, it should be write minus 0.1. For example, clock reading 0.04 or 4 per 100 is written as 4. If using an electronic instrument, round off to closest 1 per 100 millimeter. In example, minus 0.032 is written as 3. We can continue with another measurement. The point B is 90 degrees, and then point C is 180 degrees, or when the piston on the TDC or top dead center, and then point D is located on the 270 degrees, and then next is E. The E is on the about 5 or 10 before bottom dead center. We can continue with another measurement, another cylinder. Please put in your mind that we conduct one by one of each cylinder. This is to avoid that the cooldown of the cylinder, so it will make the differential temperature is high. Because when the temperature is different, it will make the measurement is also different. Make sure that the crankshaft temperature is constant during the whole procedure. Switch off any force ventilation to the engine and avoid unnecessary cooling of the engine. When measuring, open only one crankcase cover at a time and close immediately after the measurement. If you like this video, don't forget to press the like button and then subscribe this channel and press the bell button. As you can see in this video, the extension cable may drop in the sometime. So always clean up the extension cable with the waste rag to avoid any spillage on the floor. After completed all cylinder measurement, we can disconnect the transducer. As you can see, that is the place of the transducer. All cylinder having same position. The crankshaft rotation direction is following the engine rotation direction and read the deflection in the marked position A, B, C, D, E. You can see the maximum vertical deflection as per the table showing on the video. And this is the form used for recording the result of the measurement. The measurements depend on the numbers of the cylinder. At previous measurement, the cylinder is 6 pieces. The sagging moment is treated as positive bending moment and the hooking as negative bending moment. And this is the result of the measurement of all cylinders. The result of the measurement of number 4 main generator engine or DFDVE is under good condition. The highest value is minus 0.95 and the allowable limit is 0.12 mm. Please take note that minus 0.95 is the value of the reading. And in millimeter, it is 0.0095. Millimeter. As you can see from the graph, the value minus, it means it is hogging. It is negative bending moment. I think that's all my short explanation how to conduct crank web deflection measurement. If you have any advice, suggestion or question, please write on the comment below and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching my video. See you. If you have any advice, suggestion, or question, please write in the comment below. And thank you for watching my video. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you. See you. Bye bye.